Hello and welcome guys, this is Tuhin. Welcome to my channel Prani Jeans. Today I'm going to share about one of the most important element, that is MCQ. You must make a proper plan for preparation of the MCQ also, along with the other things what is being important. I have a 4 point what I need to share and to boost up your knowledge for the MCQ. The first one, when you are studying your mat, you must focus on the small points which can be asked as a MCQ questions. You must observe the topics, which you must mark that area, and every time you do the revision you must have a view over that marked area in terms of MCQ. Like you can see, I have marked in my book while I was in a study process in portfolio chapter, and another question in MCQ under the CAPM model, they can ask these kind of questions also, which I have marked. I have also marked some of the interview based question. When I have given the interview for the hardcore training, some of the technical questions they have asked during the interview, so that thing is being kept in the mind, and I have marked some of the interview based question also. So while you are in study, you must keep in your mind in regards to the MCQ questions, and just keep on observing that which question could be asked as a MCQ. Make a proper judgment to it. It will boost your knowledge also. The second one I wanted to talk about is for a scanner. There are lots of MCQs being given in the scanner. You must go through a scanner also. That will be very helpful, and I am saying this with my personal experience for the examination. That will be really helpful for me at the time of intermediate also, and at the time of final also. Do one thing, do not start from the beginning. You must start from the last attempt of the questions which is being given in their examination. Like for now, you must attend the June 19 term of MCQ. Up to June 15 or 14 might be, that will be enough. And there you should mark with a red pen and a green pen. The red pen should shows that which must be go through before the examination, and if possible then solve also. And the green pen will show that you can overview it before the examination, and you can do it in your own way, but surely you must use some mark like a green pen or a red pen, which is more important and which is less important. The third one I wanted to talk about is of MTP. This is also very important to do before the examination, when you did the full revision and you are a bit confident about yourself that you can able to give your best in the examination. Then solve these MCQ without looking after the answer. And the best suggestion what I can give you, and what I did, I solved the MCQs after having the full revision and give marks to myself, and generally 16 to 18 marks every time I get whenever I solve the MCQ over after the revision without looking after the answer. So this will give really a confident at that time before the examination that okay, at least MCQ I can solve with my fullest level. At least you are confident about the MCQs, that means 20 marks, and I'm sure you can also secure 16 to 18 marks in the MCQ very effortlessly if you give a bit time from now to the MCQ preparation. The fourth point that I wanted to talk about is for workbook. In workbook, the MCQ question is being given chapter wise, which is very good and helpful for the students. Now it's time for the revision, so whenever you do the revision chapter wise, go through the MCQ of the workbook simultaneously along with the every chapter you do for the revision. It will take hardly 5 minutes to revise chapter wise each MCQ when do you do the revision. Do one thing, use some mark and like a red pen and a green pen, so that you can just overview it again and again whenever you do the revision, so that you do not need to give any extra effort for the revision of the MCQ in the workbook. Guys, every day 30 to 40 minutes must be given to the MCQ from the scanner also, because that is also very important. Good luck guys, this is what I need to say for the MCQ. Just give your best effort and you will achieve your result. Just start generating belief on yourself that you can do this. And if you did the hard work with a full faith, then you will surely get the return of that hard work also. With that belief, you must go ahead and give your best effort in the examination. Follow the plan what you have made for yourself. Make a proper implementation of it. Have a consistency and maintain a discipline in your life before the examination. You must do it. Remember one thing, discipline and regret both are painful. but you have to make a choice that which pain you want, whether it's a discipline and a regret. Make your own choice. Guys, if you want to connect with me, you can message me over my Facebook profile. This is my Facebook profile. You can message me and we can talk over any problem, whatever you have, we can discuss over it. So thank you so much, guys. Meet you over the next video. Till then, goodbye. Thank you.